Hi. Come on in, please.
I happen to be in the neighborhood, so I decided to check in on her.
I'm either in or around, but that doesn't matter, Fred. I've longed for a one-on-one opportunity with you, and I'm sure you know that. Oh, come on, Fred. Don't give me that look, Fred.
You're handsome. You're sexy. Strongly built. Fred, you're just my pure kind of man.
Ever since then, she went at the restaurant, you've never stopped sending my heart racing. But I don't just know why you keep snubbing my passes. Come, sweetie.
You'll find me.
Look, I give it to you that you're quite tempting. But I'd rather stick with Anita. Please, where did she go to?
Well, if you must know, Anita has gone to nurse her children.
What did you just say?
You heard me. Does that look like what I share with Anita? Don't give me that look, please. Listen, Fred. Your darling Anita has put a huge wool over your eyes. She has two children, and that's why she can't take you to where she lives.
I don't believe a single word of what you just said now. Listen to me. This is cheap blackmail on my friend.
Point of correction. Anita is not my friend. I don't even know where she lives. Okay.
Stay away from me. I don't want any more of your lies and deception.
Listen, forgive me. I didn't mean to lie to you.
What you did. And it doesn't matter anymore because it's over between us.
Oh, don't talk like that. I love you so much. I have suffered so much heartache because of those children. I was afraid of losing you, okay? I didn't want you to abandon me like the rest.
I suspected there was something so discreet about you all along. But I guess I was too blind and in love to notice it. Right now, I don't even know what to believe about you. Whether you're just a cheap liar, denying your parents and children, or you're just simply were taking advantage of innocent men. Look, I don't want you in my life anymore. You're right? Look, I'm sure that's how you got stuck with those children in the first place. Out of my...
Demonic bitch masquerading as a friend whilst you're nothing but a dangerous backstabbing bitch. Did I ask you to live a life of promiscuity, Anita? Did I? How dare you label me a prostitute?
Oh, prostitute. A trader knows better the name of her trade. Let's even start it first. Isn't that what you are? Huh? What other type deserves you if not a prostitute, Anita? Young girl producing babies everywhere for no man? Listen, my dear. I deserve a decent girl and not you.
You are evil, Harriet. Worse than the chameleon itself. So you did all of this to destroy my fortunes with Fred? All for what? Jealousy?
See who is calling names. Fortunes. What a laugh. Do you know how long I've eyed Fred? Do you know that? Oh, so you think you became proper from nowhere with your filthy baggage to claim it to yourself? You will lie, Anita. You lie. Fred deserves a decent girl and not you.
To adopt the children as mine. I also want to get married to you.
You're just saying that to make me happy. You're not really
look, Anita, I'm very serious about this. Children are your blessing. And I want them. Alright? To know when to bring my people for the formal introduction and subsequent formalities.
I don't know when it will be convenient for you and your people. I will leave you to pick the date, then communicate to us.
Okay. That's okay by me, sir. You will get to hear from us very soon.
No problem.
Let's sit back and watch you bring in that loose woman into this family. She's not even your class.
Mom, look. Class has no bearing in my affection for Anita. Look, that lady is the one loving and intelligent lady who only happens to be burdened by the mistake she made way back in the past.
Fred, that burden is what this family cannot afford to bear.
Are you kidding me? Two kids?
Stay away from me. Alright? This is totally my affair. She's my choice.
Okay. a terrible choice, Fred, and I can't stand in for it. You cannot marry that girl. She might be a professional prostitute for all we know.
Enough. This family will not have you bring that second value, is it third hand value girl, into its fold. I spent quite a lot of money training you for you to know better.
My son will not carry other men's responsibilities.
Fred, I know you are due to settling down into a nice, quiet family life.
That's why I have been doing my best trying to get you a decent, worthy woman. And you know what? I found her.
Cheryl, Chief Allison's daughter. She's a marketing expert based in the United States. Well-groomed in our cultural values. I'm sure both of you will make a perfect couple. I was only waiting for the right time to introduce you.
Dad, I already have a wife to be.
Oh, shut up there. Listen to your father.
I know my son. He's being infatuated with that girl at the moment. Don't worry, Fred. You wait until you meet Sherry, huh?
That's very interesting.
Yes, we call that toxicity.
Dad?
Oh!
Welcome.
Welcome, son.
Welcome. Mom.
Meet Cheryl. My friend's daughter that I told you about. She arrived from the United States last night.
Welcome back. Let me take this. I'm guessing you had an active day today at work.
Come, Cheryl. Out. Let me show you to the drill.
So, what do you think?
She's pretty, alright. But that means nothing to me.
We'll leave both of you together for a few days so you can get acquainted. Just keep your mind open, okay?
All right, I'll join you later.
He's gonna like that. He's gonna like that.
Have for breakfast, so I opted for a variety of choices.
How early did you wake up to make all this? You didn't need to go through all this. I mean, you should have simply woken me up to ask.
I'm not in the habit of disturbing people's sleep. except if absolutely necessary. You never can tell the extra few minutes of sleep might just be what the person needs to pull through into your day. So...
Interesting. Okay, we'll just have the porridge and the fresh fish.
Okay, just take a seat. I have a special way of serving my meals. Go on, sit down. Don't bother going out for lunch today, because I'll come back by your office and bring you Bengasi and pounded yam.
Pounded yam? I'm always going to pound the yam.
I do pound. Well, I'm not going to pretend as a favorite hobby. I'm aware of the fact that there are blending machines out there, but I don't like the texture they bring out, so I stick to the natural blend.
I must say, you really amaze me. After spending 5 years in the US, you still have not lost that home flavor. While Lillian here cannot even make banga soup, let alone pound yam.
I'd rather say it's early to judge. Mm-hmm. Why not taste it, else you'll be disappointed.
I have an idea of what I'm tasting here. So I look forward to that banga soup.
I was wondering when we'll get around to that.
I don't know what you think about this matchmaking idea of my dad. But I guess you've not been told that there's somebody I intend to get married to.
I'm not particularly in search of a husband, Fred, to tell you the truth. I have a good number of suitors pestering me for marriage, both in the US and down here. But dad just keeps mentioning yours as preferred choice for me. I've known your dad for a while, through mine, and he happens to be a man I admire so much. I was wondering if the son is half a good quality as he is. The only reason I'm here is to see if you're what as much hype as you've been given. It doesn't matter. You said you're in love with someone else. I think you should go be with her. You should be with the one your heart truly desires.
Hello.
Hi.
I'm here to see Fred.
Fred in?
It's Fred in.
No, he's not in.
But his cars are all parked.
I just said you can't see him. Are you deaf?
Okay.
You cannot disturb this place with your stupid calls.
Excuse me.
I never said I was in love with her. Okay, maybe I was. But certain recent events have shaken the basis of my feelings towards her.
Could that be?
I found out she's a mother of two. A fact she completely hid away from me.
Wow, that's serious.
Honestly, I've been battling with my heart whether I can live with this. But her presence has altered everything. I mean, I fought my family doggedly when all this makeup issue came up. But now I have no doubt
But you're the best thing that ever happened to me. Cheryl, you fit into everything I want in a woman. And that's why I want us to make this work.
You're a perfect gentleman, Fred. No man has ever been with me for 1 week without wanting to sleep with me. But you, on the same bed for 7 whole days. No one has ever respected me that much. And that's why I found it difficult to choose from a lot.
So, do I take this to mean yes?
Can I have my phone back? Anyway, what have I done to deserve this kind of hostility from you?
Posing your bastard children on my brother is a terrible enough reason, don't you think?
We have settled that.
Settled what? Huh? Settled what? Oh, you think by using diabolical means to blindfold Fred will help you pave your way through? You lie. You still have me and the rest of the family members to contend with. The reasons for having can play dirty and nasty when the push comes through. Don't you dare stand in front of a moving train, because we would crush you without even looking back. I'll take this for you. Get out! Yeah, that's where you belong.
You. Oh God. Tell me, why won't you sleep all through working hours after selling your body at brothels? Tell me, why won't you?
Don't you ever say that to me again.
And what would you do? Fight me or beat me? Rubbish.
Child.
Stop it, sister. Why do you hate your children so much? Is it their fault when you got yourself pregnant?
Don't you shut up your mouth there. Don't think you're any better than them. Because I also hate you. I hate all of you in this house.
Pastor, come to my
medical attention would have been disastrous.
Well, I give God all the glory.
Can we see Anna?
I'm afraid you can't see her yet. She refuses to see or speak to anyone, but she'll be alright. But I wonder what could have pushed such a young girl into so extreme state of depression that could warrant her one to terminate her life.
Well, doctor, She's been through a lot lately. It's a very long story.
Well, I suggest that as soon as she gets out of here, she gets the best professional psychological counseling and therapy. Otherwise, whatever led her into this attempt will cause her to have a second attempt. And you know, most people don't get lucky twice.
Don't forget. I understand what you're saying. But I assure you we'll do our best. Thank you very much, Doctor.
Anita, the doctor said you were saved by your breath. Is it worth it? That you were willing to throw your life away because a man turned his back on you?
I'm not like you. With all the privileges in this life, Michelle.
You think coming from a wealthy background counts for all the privileges in this life? I agree with you that it helps. But let me tell you something. The greatest of life privileges are the ones you only can offer to yourself, not your background, nor your past. Anita, at your age now, what you need is self-empowerment, not necessarily a husband. Let me tell you, you already have enough distraction from the children. If you ask me, you getting married now will only distract you, and that will take you away completely from the path of good education.
Fred promised to send me back to school, if not for his family.
Fred's action has nothing to do with his family if he truly loved you. Anita, you of all people should know that a man's promises often count for nothing as they soon expire with the words.
I want to go back to school. But Michelle, you and I know that my parents can't afford it.
Anita, I know many indigent students in my school whose parents can't even afford their school fees. But they push on through self-determination by doing many jobs in town and exploring other God-given talents in them to survive. Anita, poverty is only in the mind. It's not an excuse. But don't worry, okay? Yes, sir.
But first, I must say. So, tell me, why do you want to apply for the post of a cleaner? I mean, we have other vacancies like secretaries and the like. So, why a cleaner?
I know, sir. But it's just that I don't have the qualification. I did not complete my secondary school.
No, you don't say. Yet you speak and write so well. All right. You know what? I do not think you need an interview. You have the job.
Wow. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Congrats. You have the job. But I advise you to do something about completing your education. It's very important. Okay. Your course please do that. If you ask me, you're very brilliant, so don't let that, you know, go down the drain. Okay? Okay.
Yeah, hello, Abigail. Please prepare a fresh employment letter for our new cleaner. Yeah, Miss Anita. Yes, right away. And yeah, on your way out, you should be able to find the receptionist's office. She would show you the secretary's office where you can open the documentation forms. Yeah, you can start work on Monday morning.
Congrats.
You're welcome. You too. again. Look, your call time is 8 a.m. I've said that to you before. Right?
I know, sir, but you come early to work and I get embarrassed when I come to work and you're already here and I have to clean the place.
Listen, Anita, I've said this to you before. My coming to work very early is just me. It's my work ethic. And I don't think anyone should be a victim of that. Not even you. Okay? So your call time is 8 a.m. I mean, this is too early.
I actually love to work early too, sir.
It's just impossible. Anyway, I've been meaning to ask you. Have we met before? I know there's something very familiar about you, like I've seen you somewhere before. I can't put it together right now. Have we?
I doubt it, sir.
Okay. I can't put my hands on it right now, so I'll just let it go. But, yeah, this one is important. What happened to your education? You know, a young lady like you should either be in school or be rounding up right now. So, what happened? Is it that you lost your parents early?
No, sir.
Okay, so, what is it then? You couldn't afford the fees?
It's a long story, sir.
Oh, a long story. On a day that I have time to listen. I'm listening.
Sir, I'd rather not talk about it, please.
Come. Yeah. You know, I have, I've watched you closely over the last couple of weeks since you've been working here, and I must say, I'm impressed, you know. I'm impressed by your maturity. You've carried yourself in a very special way, and every time I look at you, I just can't help but think, hey, she's gonna make a wonderful wife, you know. Forgive me, this is not meant to upset you, okay, but... I won't be out of place if I tell you I'm really falling for you.
I'm married, sir.
Sorry, what? What did you say? You're married? I'm sorry. I just can't put it together. You made it very clear in your application here that you were single and now you're telling me you're married. I'm sorry, I can't put it together. Is it that you lied to this company? Or you're lying to me? Which?
I'm sorry, sir.
You're sorry? You're sorry that you lied, or you're sorry that you're married?
For all, both of the two, I'm sorry about, okay, I'm not married. But I don't need a husband too.
I'll let you finish up. I'll be outside. Let me know when you're done. So I would like you to go back to school. You know, complete your education, and it's important. And as I speak with you, I've made a few calls, spoken with a few people, and
I'm sure we can find you a very good school around town. Miss Anita, you can do this if you put your mind to it. Go back to school, complete SS3, sit for JAMB, get admission into the university, pick a course of your choice and live your dream.
Thank you, sir. But I'll do that when I can afford to do so.
Okay. Can we do away with the sir? Because you know, when you talk like this, I begin to wonder if you do not believe in the seriousness of my heart. What I ask is that you give us a chance. I want to see you exploit your full potentials. I want to see you fly. I want to see you live your dream, Anita. All I'm asking is that you give us a chance. I want to see you exploit your full potentials. I want to see you fly. I want to see you live your dreams.
Sir, sorry. I mean, I just want to say that there are so many girls you could choose from out there to be your wife. I'm not of your class.
You've already rushed into a new relationship so soon after what happened between you and Fred.
Collins is way different from Fred.
Are you sure? Tell me, how long have you known him to think he would treat you any different?
I have strong feelings for Collins, Michelle.
Anita, you always have strong feelings about the men you meet. Listen, that's not the way to live. He's your boss, for crying out loud.
I know, but...
No, you don't know, Anita. Messing around with one's boss only ends in terrible heartache. Let me tell you, they only use you to satisfy their lust, then dump you.
You know, you talk like you've had such an experience before.
No, I haven't. That does not mean I should be stupid not to learn from people who have gone through it. Anita, I know many such people.
Michelle, leave her. Let her keep deceiving herself. You think any well-educated young man can ever settle down with a common illiterate like you? No. Anita, it's obvious you haven't learned from Fred's experience.
Leave Fred out of this, Mabel.
Oh, you're right. You're too dumb to face the truth. Michelle, I'm leaving before she asks me again to learn my parents to her, to introduce to her new guy.
Get out.
I wish you the best of happiness in life. Be careful, okay? I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay.
Mama. I want to bring Colin soon to meet with their family.
Has he come out open?
Yes, he's been pestering me. I'm the one who's been avoiding him from coming here.
Why?
Mommy, you should know why now.
Anita. Anita!
Mommy, I need a favor from you. I want you to help me take the kids to Auntie Rachel's house this weekend so that I can bring Collins here. On Sunday.
That's not a good idea if you ask me. Tell Collins you have children. You can't hide them from him forever.
Mama, I know all of that. But I will tell him. Not until I get a commitment from him.
Wrong. This is the exact mistake you keep making.
I have everything worked out this time around, okay? No, I can't afford to lose Collins like the other men. Please.
All right.
Thank you.
I will send for Rachel to come over and take the children.
You will send the children to nowhere. Why are you so selfish, Anita? If you abandon these children just like their father did, who's going to be parent to them?
I'm not abandoning them.
Will you shut your mouth? I swear to you, if you send those children out of this house just because you want to bring a man here, I will personally tell him the truth. Try me.
That's not fair. Mama, tell him something now. Mama, please, this is not fair.
Around the other person.
It's okay, we'll find our way around. Thank you.
Thank you. It's nice doing business with you, Mr. Gray.
Same here.
Happy stay.
Yeah. I'll call you.
All right, bye-bye.
Hey, welcome home, baby.
Yeah.
I'm sure you're going to love it here.
Yeah, it looks like a nice and lovely place.
All right, let's go in.
Sweetie, I hope you're not disappointed in me.
Why should I be disappointed in you? Look. It's not your fault that you're barren, okay? Kids are a gift from God. Don't worry, when we finalize this, I'll go bring my kids. Okay? It's a child. Don't worry yourself about it. I love you.
Yeah, you're such a wonderful person. I love you.
As I said earlier on, I will kindly entreat you to tell Anita and your husband, make them understand I have to take the kids away. Look, Anita, try and understand me. It's for the betterment of both of us. These kids, I need to take them away.
Hey! Come and discuss!
day and night. And it's such a shame, your vanity is to blame. Oh, why don't you knock it off? It's the pointlessness that's got me loving less. I cannot handle that, you're such a
thanks for giving me audience.
I only have a moment to spare.
Why don't we go to a more relaxing place so I'll give you a treat? Okay, I'll just go straight to the point. I want to take custody of the children. I want to give them proper education and good upbringing.
You want just the children?
But it's a bit complicated, Anita. I'm married.
Wow. How heartless could you be, Greg? You abandoned me with a 9-month pregnancy and a year-plus child, and travel to God knows where, only for you to return and tell me that you're married and that I should give you my children? How wicked could you be?
Look, I'm sorry. I had to do what I did. I needed to pursue my future.
A future that didn't include me in it? Greg, so after all the humiliation and suffering you put me through, what did I ever do to wrong you? Did I ever do anything to hurt you? Am I not worthy to be a wife to you? I could have waited for you, Greg.
Kanita, I'm so sorry. You won't understand, okay? I'm sorry for the pain I caused you. Look, I can compensate you with a huge sum of money just to start up a business. All I ask is to take custody of my children.
You want me to give you my children? You're married. Won't your wife give you children?
Let's be more realistic here, Anita. You and I know you're not capable of giving the children a quality life. I want the best of everything for my children. The best of education, the best of life, the best of everything. Please, don't deny them what you can afford. Please, I beg you.
Go away, Greg. And don't you dare come near my children.
How can I just let you walk away? Just let you leave without a trace. When I stand here taking every breath with you, ooh, you're the only one who really knew me at all. How can you just walk away from me when all I can do is watch you leave? 'Cause we've shared the laughter and the pain.
Every night and day, I will secretly pray for him to be successful in his fortunes he went to seek, and hope that one day he would come home to me and the children.
Anita, this is a very delicate situation. How could he betray you so? And still have the guts to ask you to hand the children to him, just like that.
Why is my life so unfortunate?
I have no ready answer to that, Anita. But what I have to tell you is to be careful not to take the decision that will make it worse.
I'm not handing him the children.
No, you shouldn't. but you must get him to take responsibility for their education.
How?
You have to be firm, Anita. Let him know that his only license to seeing the children is if he takes responsibility to educate them, but not out of your sight. He doesn't have a choice. It's obvious he doesn't want to see his children poorly educated.
When you least expect.